Welcome back to Let's Interactively Play Steve Jackson's Sorcery. I'm the RPG Chick, and as always, for any newcomers, this is a Let's Play where you choose what to do at the end of the video, and that will, you know, continue into the succeeding video next week. Now I'm going to quickly restart the recording to try to, well, we had some audio-video desync last time, so I'm not sure what that was all about. Okay, hopefully that's good. So it was unanimous last time that we should ward off the serpent. And I do have one ration I can take. I'm not sure what, I'm not sure if warding off the serpent will make it leave, defeat it, or it'll come back. I hate to use my one ration, but you know, I'm gonna do it. Kind of reminds me of, what do you call it? Skyrim. Eating food to get back hit points. I also have this water gourd. What if I drink from the water gourd instead, actually? Nothing? Nothing. Gives us 2 hit points. Or 2 stamina, rather. I don't know if that's a random thing or if it would always be 2. I've seen it more before, but let's ward off the serpent. You lift a flame in front of your face and wave it back and forth, hoping to drive the serpent back, but it seems the fire truly is the serpent's weakness. The flame seems to leap onto the serpent's body. One by one, the scales pop from its hide, peeling back and falling like leaves to the rocks below. The creature is screaming now, in pain and terror. Well, that was stupid. I didn't act afraid of it when I conjured the fireball. So it just stays there. I guess it called my bluff and now it's paying the price. I'm not going to allow it to recover. Let's draw a sword and kill it. Okay, so it is damaged. It's got only 6 points here. You draw your sword, ready to finish the serpent off. The serpent darts low and you set yourself for battle. I'm gonna start off defend. I think that was wise. You ready your blade. Even though it is weakened, you will need your wits about you against this foe. You take 2 steps back across the dust and raise your guard. The serpent stumbles forward, tracing a painful arc towards you, only to crash against your defense. Cold gathers around the edges of the serpent's mouth. Okay, I'm gonna do cut here. Boom! Chopped it right in half of the points it had anyway. You sense the serpent panting for strength. You dodge right. Blade low and strong. The serpent is moving to try and encompass you. You hold your ground and drive your blade into its open jaw. The silvery glow around the creature seems to wane a little. The serpent's skin lessens in color. Can I cut now? I wasn't even going to do anything. You press your advantage, knowing only too well this is a fight to the death. You strike forward, pushing in deep. The moon serpent scrabbles backwards, escaping the most of your swing. Silvery moons are winking out across the creature's long back. The creature coils its scaly body. I can only sideswipe. I have a feeling it's going to try to attack now out of desperation. So I'm going to defend. Oh, it's a weak strike anyway. A cold glow surrounds the creature and you feel it trying to draw life from your bones. You drop away as the serpent lashes out weakly with the cruelly turned tip of its tail. The creature gathers, its failing strength opening its mouth wide and baring teeth like daggers. Try a cut? Good. For a moment it seems like the creature is pausing. A rapid stab bites into the serpent's half-moon scales. The moon serpent's eyes close to narrow crescents, then fall dark. Its body seems to crumble before your eyes. 2 stamina lost. Skilled swordplay. Why, thank you. Yay! I love it. Very loud. I paused because I figured you guys couldn't hear me very well over that. You have now defeated two of the Seven Serpents. The darkness in the sky disappears, and the sun returns as the serpent dies. It seems to coil up, shriveling away until all that remains is a small crystal orb. Cool, of course I'm going to take it. You lift the orb. It is a precious artifact of great power. You put it carefully into your pack. The bleak mountainside falls silent around you. Your good cheer is tempered by the knowledge that you have barely begun to defeat your enemies. There are, after all, still five serpents left. Yeah, we've done a lot of exploring. In this area to the west, I have a feeling that we're going to find another one. Because after all this, give you some perspective here, all this is unexplored. We were unable to get over this bridge. So we've explored this side and this whole area. And I want to refocus the lens this way and then explore it in the past, which was probably a more garden-like area. So I want to look at this. Actually, is it a magical item? Orb of crystal. Cool. Now this holy water might heal us, but it's also part of a spell, so it's probably more effective with the spell. Or maybe it does nothing if we just drink it. Look west. Looking back west across the plains, you spy a dark smudge on the land, a cloud of black dust rising from the wheels of a great caravan of carts and horses crawling slug-like across the dust. Look around the clearing. You look around the clearing. The marks of your battle with the Moon Serpent are still visible in the dirt. There's nothing else here except for a little stone walk by the eastern edge of the plateau. The remains of a building, perhaps? Or a ledge? Can I look east and then at that? Looking east, you see the plains continuing, and then the edge of the forest of Snata, dark and tangled. Somewhere beyond is the distant glitter of Lake Ilklala, which you must, somehow, get across. The edge of the mountaintop ends abruptly. There are a few carved stones, and then a vertical drop. Ooh. Look over the eastern edge. You creep to the edge of the plateau and peer down. The drop is not vertical after all, but skitters away down the mountainside. You might be able to skid down it, though you couldn't walk and there would be a constant danger of rolling. Time to head for lower ground, one way or the other. Yeah, we got steps here, and we have south. Let's head south. I guess we'll explore the southern edge first. I'm gathering the rolling they're talking about is that way? The ground rises and falls. The sun continues to climb the steep sky. From the middle distance, a curious sound reaches your ears. Stop and listen. You stop and listen. The sound is some kind of screech. Quiet, but close at hand. The mountainside is barren, and there is nothing that could be causing the sound. Go closer. I don't want to race downhill. Should I cast a... I only have 9 stamina right now. I really don't want to use my stamina to sense for danger. Go closer. You stride forward towards the noise. Then something appears that makes you hold your pace. Hanging in midair are a pair of disembodied eyes staring right at you. Stare back. You stare at the eyes. There is something behind them, some kind of thought or intelligence, and the more you stare, the more you understand. The screeching noise is very loud. Whatever is causing it must be very close at hand. Shake my head. Shake my head. You shake your head to clear the spell of the eyes, and for a moment you are able to make out a strange disturbance in the air about 10 yards ahead, just behind a craggy boulder. The sound becomes a high-pitched mocking laugh. Keep watching. Oh boy. You stand your ground and watch. A fearful shape begins to form, a dark cowled creature with a skull-like head. Oh, you look very dangerous and very undead. It beckons with a single bony finger. Beckons. Is it pointing at me? Run for cover in the rocks? With the... What's misspelled? With the apparition's laughter ringing in your ears, you turn and race through across the rocks, tripping and stumbling down the mountainside, cutting and bruising yourself with every fall. I didn't want to do all that. The death wraith's laughter seems to follow you as you go, shrill, piercing, and cruel. Do we dare look back? You turn back to see the shape shimmering and flickering the air. Although the laughter is still ringing out across the stone, the apparition itself seems to be disappearing. So I've lost stamina. I've lost 2 stamina. Just doing that. Go back and look. This does not feel right. You suspect a trap. You stop running and begin to clamber up the mountainside, moving slowly and carefully across the stones. After a few paces, you catch sight of a cowed, balding man, hiding behind an outcrop of stone and giggling to himself. Okay, do we have an illusionist here? Who are you? You demand. The creature does not take his arms from over his head. Leave Renfren alone. He never does any harm. Just a little merriment, that's all. Behind you, the apparition has vanished. A mere illusion. I've never seen apparitions spell that way. Apparition? How did you learn this illusion? You demand. From a traveler, he replies, still bowing and scraping the ground as he walks. And actually talks. She traded me a bracelet of bone for some food. She was starving to death, trying to get to Mampang, she said. But I don't think she was going to make it. She was so hungry. She showed me how it was done. Where is this woman now? You ask, remembering the others sent off from Annaland on the same quest before you. No, I want the bracelet of bone. Or do I have the bracelet of bone? Let me finish reading what he says. But the man only shrugs. How should I know? Probably in the belly of a snatticat or at the bottom of Lake Iklala. Then he pales. But nothing to do with me. You can't suspect me. I can't, huh? Bracelet of bone. I have a bracelet of bone. Okay. It's to use as a spell. I mean you no harm. You declare, shaking your head. Which is more than can be said for you. The man squirms with self-pity. Of course, he pleads. I should have known better when I saw you. I knew, I thought, you're a warrior. You're a wizard. I could tell. And yet you tried to trick me? From his pocket, he produces a spiked metal disc and a yellow vial of powder. Take them, he begs. What's in the vial? You ask. I don't know what the powder is, he says. I just like the color. A spiked metal disc. Take the disc. You take the metal disc. You lift the vial of yellow powder to the light as you take it. It is a fine, grainy powder, the color of unchafed wheat or pus. Ugh. Thank you, Renfren replies, bowing his head almost to the dust. I'm going to look at those in a second. What do you know of the Seven Serpents? You ask. The man's eyes open wide. The Seven Serpents? He nods violently. Oh, yes, of course. I know the Serpents. I know all of them. All 7. What can you tell me about them? Oh, he replies vaguely, waving a hand skyward. You know, they fly around, don't they? Have you seen them? Yes, and he nods vigorously. I see them quite often. I think he is lying to us. What else do you know? You demand. Nothing, he says flatly. I don't know nothing. I mean, I don't know any more than nothing. Nothing's what I know. He changes his tactics and seals his lips. Do you live out here in the backlands? I already asked him about the Deathwraith. You ask, looking around the wilderness. He begins to weep. I used to be a sailor. My captain was a brute. We landed ashore and I ran off into the wasteland, and I've been wandering them ever since. This place is cursed, you know that? You think you've reached the edge, and then somehow you find yourself back where you started. It's like the ground itself was built in spirals. He waggles his finger in the air, round and round. Yeah, I can see that, I guess. Tell me how you conjured the Deathwraith, see if he says anything else. You demand, unless you are very much mistaken, this man is no sorcerer. He shrugs. Oh, it's just a thing I learned to do. It's all smoke and mirrors, you know. Where did you learn? You ask. He looks uncomfortable. From a woman I met, he replies. I helped them, you see, and they helped me. Help them how? Fed them, he replies, giggling slightly. Hard to eat when you're at the bottom of a pit trap. Renfren nods and smiles charmingly at you. He moves to one side, putting a low boulder between you and him. Then he starts running, as fast as his legs will carry him. I'm going to let him go, mostly because I don't want to end up tumbling down the mountain again and losing more stamina. You let him go. He's not worth wasting your energy on. You turn your attention to the path ahead. Alright, let's see what we have. Magical items. Is it a magical item? Yellow powder. And what's the other thing I got? A disc of some kind? Serpent. Chakram. That's a weapon? A spiked throwing disc. Sweet. I wonder how effective that is. So he gave us some yellow powder and a chakram weapon. A spiked throwing disc. Could I make ranged attacks with that? I mean, we haven't seen ranged yet. It's always been melee combat. I'm trying to see if anything uses this yellow powder. Not stone dust. Oh, yellow powder. Okay. For a haste spell. Nip. Alright, that's cool. I might use that at some point. Maybe against another challenging... what do you call it? Serpent. Haste powder. Maybe I'll get to attack more than, like, twice around or something like that. That'd be sweet. Okay, so let's continue downhill towards some kind of ruins here. I love the exploration in this game, gotta say. You climb down the mountain and join the old road. The mid-afternoon heat floods the region. Okay, we got west ruins, follow the road, or northwest to this village or huts or something. Let's go to the ruin, if that's what that is. You step off the road and walk across the desolate plain. Heat beats down from an empty sky. You are climbing up a low, rocky rise, not a natural outcrop as you first assumed, but rather a pile of large carved blocks over which the dust of many ages has blown. I can search The rubble? Climb the rubble. Cast a spell or move on. Let's search. You peer in between the larger stone blocks and shift a few smaller ones out of the way. You see nothing, and then a glimpse of blue shines through. A gem? A small lizard scurries out from between two of the fallen blocks. Ooh. Gotta try for it. Something's gonna reach out and bite me. You try to squeeze your hand into a crack in the stone to reach the blue gleam of crystal, but it is still only just visible under a heap of large stones. You cannot get close enough to reach. I suppose climbing the rubble would get me a better vantage point. Let's look in my pack for something useful. You open your pack and look for something you can use to knock the crystal free. Use the walking stick, the magic chain. I don't want to use my sword because we seem to always dull the blade. Use the walking stick, I think. You lower the cane through the gap in the middle. You knock the crystal with the end of the walking stick into a gap between the stones where you should be able to reach it. Touch the blue crystal. You touch the blue crystal and start to rise upwards. Is this a ruined tower? It's a ruined tower. Really? So if I change this, if I make this ray face this way, I'll be able to access the tower before it fell. I'm sure. I'm sure of it. Whoa. You return downwards. You are back by the ruined blocks of the tower in the plains. You know? We might be able to teleport between towers like that. I think I'm going to try that when we leave this area. When we're done here. I'll try to teleport to that other tower. And then move the ray around, the light. So, unfortunately it didn't give me hit points back. Climb up the rubble. You clamber to the top of the stack of stone to try to get a view of the plain, but from the top you can see little more than you could from the bottom. Alright. You walk away from the tumbled stones. How sad. That whole one was destroyed. Alright, that's back. Let's head this way first. Cover this southern area. Or some of it. You walk on across the waste until you meet the edge of an old road. Slowly the sun begins to lower in the sky. The plains are wide and empty. To the south the fissure yawns, wider here, and furiously deep. Alright, let's head west. Gonna rest soon, probably. You abandon the road and cut across the gray plain. The sun lowers toward the horizon. The road is barely visible through the dust. A few scattered bones line the path. Look at the bones. You pick over a few of the bones. Thin femurs, long arms. Elven, most likely, or black elf. The wind has scoured them dry. You stride onwards. Just going to take a look across the view here. The sun is now in the lowest quarter of the sky. It will be night soon. You follow the old road to the edge of the fissure. The bleak plains stretch away once more. Behind you, wind whistles through the fissure. I'm gonna move on. You waste no time. You must move on. Okay, I guess we'll head to this now. If we can. You make your slow way, actually, across the endless dusty plains. Clouds begin to tumble across the dimming sky. Soon it will be dark. Let's move here. I want to go towards that... What? You continue following the road. Another night begins. You need to rest. Suddenly the ground beneath you rumbles and begins to slide into itself. There is no time for a spell. Your arms are wide, trying to maintain your balance. Jump clear. You try to jump clear, oh crap, but can gain no decent purchase on the shifting sand. Meanwhile, the ground is falling away faster and faster from under your feet. You fall backwards, spreading out your legs to reduce your pressure on the sands. Then you scramble back as fast as possible, trying to escape the growing pit. I guess something's coming out of the sand. Let's scramble backwards some more. Oh, you scramble back just as something launches through the sand to come for you. It's a Baddu Beetle. Alright. Let's see what we can do. That doesn't require stamina, I hope. I don't have stone dust. Walk, create a shield. I mean, I'll do that if there's no other recourse. Jig. I don't have the bamboo flute. Create explosions. Yeah. So far that looks pretty good. Mud is... create quicksand. We don't have that. Mag? Protect from magic. I don't know if this thing's magic. RWJPM WM. I wish they had the letters only once. Because I'm always looking for more. Okay, let's create an explosion with our pebble. Let's see if we can weaken it. Or maybe even scare it off. Who knows? To me, I don't have like a control animal thing here. But that's not one of them. One of the ones available. You wind the constellations into alignment around you over one of your pebbles. Can I do this? Throw it into the beetle's mouth? I'll try. You wait for the beetle to stretch wide its terrible jaws, then toss the pebble in between them. There's a pause, and then a muffled explosion. The Baddu beetle's skull collapses inwards like a deflated bladder. It falls and is quickly swallowed into its own quicksand. Time to be moving on. Okay. Can I go up here and rest? Shall we rest? I want to rest. When can I rest? Let's go here, north. It's not giving me the option. You carry on tramping across the plain, keeping your eyes and ears open for warnings of danger. There is nowhere here to shelter or rest. You continue to march. What? I can't go here? This goes past it. Alright, let's head north. I mean, they look like little huts, little buildings. The stars are flooding the sky. The ground here is broken, dry mud. Deep cracks and uneven surfaces make it slow going to walk across. Look at the broken earth first. The deep fissures and layers of the mud catch your eye. It is as though the whole plain had been held high in the air and dropped. It must have been very fertile land once. In a few cracks, thick clumps of grass still manages to grow. You swing your foot through one, and it hits something quite solid. Look closer. Spotting down on your heels, you look more closely. Inside a particularly thick clump of grass, you spy something dry, gray, and round. Clear the grass aside. You begin to part the grass and reveal a familiar shape, a human skull, its upper jaw set into the soil. It is almost lost beneath the thick grass that grows from the top of the hill. The skull appears intact, no wounds or injuries. It is only lightly buried. A little soil spills between the lower front teeth. The eye sockets stare through the thick green grass that covers the scalp. Pry the skull free. I'm going to wake some undead thing. The skull is only lightly buried. A good tug should pull it free. You try, but it does not come loose. Pull harder. I'm afraid to use my sword. You pull harder this time, but the skull still doesn't budge. It seems like it must be attached to something under the soil. Yeah, maybe the neck of the skeleton. Pull really hard. You put your full weight into your grip and pull hard on the skull until something seems to snap, and you are thrown backwards, skull in hand. You leave behind a short gray stake that runs deep into the earth. The skull itself is human, weather-worn, and of no great use. Keep the skull. You put the skull into your pack in case it should come in useful later, though for what you cannot think. Okay, now I can't look at the stake. Hate that. Rest here. It is not the most comfortable place to rest, especially with the body in the ground beside you, but it will suffice. At least you have eaten well already. And I wake up, the thing's attacking me. Close my eyes. You close your eyes and let your tiredness overtake you. You dream you are a young girl once more, lying on your back near the waterfalls of Charberry Wood. Gentle spray dusts your face. You laugh, and a droplet lands in your open mouth, but when you wipe your lips, you find there is a slug there. Spit it out. You spit it out, but more and more slugs appear, until your mouth is thick with them, and you are gagging, and there seems to be nothing you can do to clear your mouth. Am I still in the dream, or is this real? Ew, that's disgusting, man. Slugs chew? Wretch? Chew? I don't know. I don't want to puke either. I gotta feel that would make me lose a point of stamina. I'm gonna puke. You feel yourself starting to retch violently, and the sensation startles you awake to find a slavering bristle beast standing over you. Its spittle is drooling into your open mouth. Yeah. Do you mind here? You're making me dream about slugs in my mouth. What do we cast on this thing? Brittle Beast? Again, a lot of combat here in the wastes. Okay, well, let's be nothing. Hey! Okay, what's... Yeah, it's create invisibility, which we don't have. Talk with animals. Well, it just wants to eat me. Oh, that's Yap. Yap and Yaz. Alright. Lightning. 3 stamina. Yeah, that's not a good idea. We only have 7 right now. R. Sharpened blade, which we don't have. Turn to stone. We don't have stone dust. Any other? A. O. No. T. Read minds. Don't have a skull cap. I wouldn't do it anyway. B. T. I wonder what starts with B that we could... That's a spell we don't have yet. I'm just gonna attack it then. Oh, look at that little thing. 6 has 6 stamina. You roll out to one side and draw your sword as you spring to your feet. So we start with a cut. A high cut. Sweet. Half dead. Bristle Beast bares its teeth, and the spines on its back spike up. You swing your sword like an axe, hoping to prune the creature. The beast lashes out with its claws, but it cannot defend itself from your force. The beast drops its head low. It's gonna attack with the spines. I'm gonna risk a cut anyway. You batter at the bristle beast, charging forward, sword biting for blood, as it tries to bash you back. The beast hisses and rattles its spines, clearly weakening. Oh, it won that one. I was afraid it would... I figured it was weakening. Then the bristle beast charges in return. You try to jab forward, but its spines enter your skin and bury themselves deep. Owie! You fall, catching a rock on the back of your head. I can only... defend... I'm gonna... Oh god, we're not doing it too well. You drop your guard down low. The bristle beast flails at you with its clawed feet. You turn the blow with your sword. It drops its jaw. Die, thing. Readying your sword, you retaliate, cutting the bristle beast down. With a final swing, you bury your blade deep into the bristle beast. It twists on the metal, then curls up like an overheated beetle and dies. 3 stamina lost. Rough going. Yeah. Shall we try again? It begins to paw the ground restlessly. I'm going to defend now, since I can only sideswipe. You drop your guard down low. The bristle beast rushes at you, scales rippling. Die. Thank you very much. One stamina loss. Decent dueling. Continue. Just because we're so low. You slump back, feeling exhausted. Okay, we went up another 2 stamina. The Plains, Day 13. During the past day, you ran out of provisions, reached the Northern Plains, and you defeated the Moon Serpent, meaning there are now only 5 serpents remaining. You get to your feet and brush the dry dust away. You walk forwards. Okay, we are open here to stuff. I could leave this off as a choice of where to go, but... Have we been there? Not completely sure. I know we haven't been to any of these, but let's be thorough. I'm not sure. I think we've been on the road. Yeah. Okay. Yellow moss. I think that's safe to eat. I think. You continue across the endless waste, watching for signs of life. There are none. The sun has not yet crested the last peaks in the east. A small patch of stones is covered by yellow moss. Gather the moss. Ooh! And I automatically ate it. Now I got 11 stamina. You gather up a handful of moss. You chew through the moss and it fills you with strength. You continue on your journey. Okay. We were here. So let's head... We haven't specifically been here, so let's just go here. We've been down there. You walk for half an hour across the dusty plains, falling into an easy stride. The air moves a little, still icy but fresh. You stride on. Okay, we've been there, so let's go north. You walk on across the plain until you join an old road. As the morning moves on, the wind begins to rise. You stop suddenly as you notice a movement in the distance. 3 shapes are approaching rapidly across the plain, throwing up a thick cloud of dust as they move. As you watch, they turn and head towards you. Hmm. Okay. I'll end it here. What do you guys think we should do? Should I hide from these 3 shapes? These men? I'm guessing they're men atop horses, but they could be beasts? They're either beasts on 4 legs, I'm thinking, or more, or they're men atop beasts of some kind. So what do you think? Should we hide? Should we hail them, or just ignore them and try to walk on? So let me know what you guys think. Please leave your votes in the comments below, and thank you very much for doing so, and thanks for watching, and endure. In enduring, grow strong. See you next week. You